So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. And guys, as you all know, the parliament session has been started. So we will have a lot of news from now on till the end of the parliament session. So please get ready for that. And in this PIB session, I have not included any question from budget, because budget I have already covered through a separate session. So if you haven't watched that session, so please go and watch that, and you will have a deep knowledge about the union budget 2022-2023, because wahan pe bahut zyada detail mein maine cover kar diya hai. So I will not take questions from budget in these PIB sessions. All right, so let's begin with the session, guys. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed with marked answers, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also ask your doubt here at Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. You can also ask anything here. So let's talk about the very first question. Very important question. Which of the following is the implementing agency for National Program for Organic Production? There is a national program for organic production which is being implemented by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So regarding that, this question is this. Now, is this a new scheme? Kya ye koi naya program hai, ye naya scheme hai? No, it is not a new program. It is not a new mission. It is not a new scheme. We are discussing about this because a written reply was submitted in the parliament with respect to this program, all right, and that's why we are discussing it. So let's talk about this. So remember, this national project on organic farming was launched in the year 2004 with three broad objectives. Iske teen bade objectives the. Number one, promotion of organic farming, as the name suggests, because the project is on organic farming, which means the promotion of organic farming must be there. So number one is promotion of organic farming in the country through technical capacity building. Number two, quality control of biofertilizers and organic fertilizers. जो biofertilizers हैं और जो organic fertilizers हैं उनका quality control. See, अब देखो क्या है कि it is not enough to replace the chemical fertilizers with the biofertilizers or the organic fertilizers. Replacement is just not enough. We have to keep the quality check. We have to keep control on the quality check of these biofertilizers and organic fertilizers. So wo bhi zaruri hai, and that is being done through this particular project, which is national project on organic farming. And number three, capacity building for soil health assessment and market development in the area of organic farming is also one of the objective of this particular project. All right, the implementing ministry for this, guys, is Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, while the nodal agency to implement this is National Center for Organic Farming, which of course is a center, is an organization under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. Narendra Singh Tomar is the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. All right, and isi se related ek aur program hai. Let's talk about that also. So there is a National Program for Organic Production. Now, what is this, by the way, and what is the difference between this and the previous one that we have studied just? So, इसमें और इसमें क्या डिफरेंस है? ये वाला जो है, जो हमने पीछे पढ़ा, that is National Project on Organic Farming, that is for promotion of organic farming. And this one, National Program for Organic Production, it is for certification of organic products. All right. So basically, the objective of this program is to provide the means of evaluation of certification program for organic agricultural products. All right. And to accredit certification programs of certification bodies which are seeking accreditation, and number three, to facilitate certification of organic products in conformity with the prescribed standards. So basically, agar hum bahut simple words mein samajhne ki koshish kare, so the objective of this national program for organic production is to strengthen the certification program for the organic products. All right, that is the objective. And the previous one that we have discussed, that is for promotion of organic farming. So please, ye difference hai, isko yaad rakhenge, theek hai? And it was launched in the year 2001, theek hai? Ye kab launch hua tha? 2001, while the previous one was launched in the year 2004. And the very important thing to remember here is that that this program is being implemented by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry and not the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. This is very important. क्योंकि जब भी ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्शन की बात आएगी तो आपका दिमाग सबसे पहले कहां जाएगा? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर की तरफ. बट दैट इज नॉट द करेक्ट आंसर. द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर इंप्लीमेंटिंग मिनिस्ट्री इज व्हाट? द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. ऑलराइट. एंड नोडल एजेंसी फॉर दिस इज अपीडा, विच इज एग्रीकल्चरल एंड प्रोसेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स एक्सपोर्ट डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी. एग्रीकल्चर एंड प्रोसेस्ड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स एक्सपोर्ट डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी इज द नोडल इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी for this national program for organic production. All right, so I hope guys these two programs are clear, and now let's come back to the question. Then question is very easy. Which of the following is the implementing agency for NPOP, which is national program for organic production? So that's APEDA. Option C will be the correct answer. National program for organic production, APEDA. Option C is the correct answer, which is agriculture and processed food export development authority. Full form bhi yaad rakhna. बहुत कॉमन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, बार बार न्यूज में आती रहती है. ठीक है, मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट्स इज द ओनली स्टेट और यूटी टू नॉट इंप्लीमेंट वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड. सो हम क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं इसके बारे में? व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट? बिकॉज छत्तीसगढ़ हैज बिकम द 35 स्टेट और यूटी. ठीक है, 35 अमंग ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटी इट इज एट द 35th नंबर टू इंप्लीमेंट वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड इन छत्तीसगढ़. ठीक है, तो छत्तीसगढ़ जो है वो अब बन गया है 35वां स्टेट अमंग ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज टू इंप्लीमेंट द वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड. ऑलराइट, एंड विद द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस इन छत्तीसगढ़, विद द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड इन छत्तीसगढ़, नाउ 96.8% ऑफ NFSA पॉपुलेशन इज अंडर द अम्ब्रेला ऑफ वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड स्कीम. And only one state. देखो टोटल हमारे पास 35 स्टेट्स और यूटीज है मिला के. सो विच इज दैट वन स्टेट विच हैज नॉट इम्प्लीमेंटेड दिस इन द स्टेट, एंड दैट स्टेट गाइज इज असम. वो स्टेट कौन सा है? असम. बट डेफिनेटली ये भी बहुत जल्दी हो जाएगा, बिकॉज लास्ट ईयर इन द मंथ ऑफ जून द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, द ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज डायरेक्टेड ऑल द स्टेट्स टू इम्प्लीमेंट वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड एज सून एज पॉसिबल. उससे पहले 4 स्टेट्स थे जिन्होंने नहीं किया था. एक था दिल्ली, वेस्ट बंगाल, छत्तीसगढ़ और असम. सो नाउ दीज 3, दिल्ली, वेस्ट बंगाल एंड छत्तीसगढ़ हैव इंप्लीमेंटेड दिस. ओनली वन इज लेफ्ट विच इज असम, जो कि बहुत जल्दी कर देगा. ऑलराइट, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट वन नेशन वन रेशन कार्ड, सो रिमेंबर द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम इज टू प्रोवाइड पोर्टेबिलिटी टू द फूड ग्रेन्स. एंड अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर इनिशिएटिव बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट the beneficiary of National Food Security Act 2013 can avail the food grains from any authorized dealer in any part of the country. वो कहीं से भी ले सकता है. ऐसा नहीं है कि जहां का उसका राशन कार्ड है वो वहीं से लेगा. It is not like that. He can avail the food grain from any authorized dealer in any part of the country. Alright, it was launched in the year 2019 and it is being implemented by Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. Alright? So, that's why the correct answer should be what, guys? Assam, option B, because they are asking the state which has not implemented this. So, option B, Assam is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. Again, very, very important question. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Atmanirbhar Bharat Center for Design? So this is something new, जिसको government लेके आ रही है, जिसको government बना रही है, Atmanirbhar Bharat Center for Design. Now what is this center? Let's talk about this. And it is in news because an MOU has been signed between 3 organizations. इसके respect में for the development of this center, an MOU has been signed. And these 3 organizations, guys, are State Bank of India, Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts and National Culture Fund. These are the 3 organizations among which an MOU has been signed for the development of this center. Alright, now what is this center? Let's talk about this. Remember, this center aims to highlight, promote and celebrate the products which have got the GI tag. Aise products jinko GI tag mila hai, unko highlight karne ke liye, unko promote karne ke liye aur unko celebrate karne ke liye this center will be established. And where will it be established? At Red Fort. Aur kaun sa wala Red Fort? Delhi wala ya Agra wala? Delhi. ठीक है, न्यू दिल्ली में जो रेड फोर्ट है वहां पे ये सेंटर एस्टैब्लिश होगा, ठीक है। एंड द इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी, ठीक है, बेसिकली जो पूरा दारोमदार है वो किसके ऊपर है, दैट इज ऑन इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल सेंटर फॉर आर्ट्स एंड कल्चर, ठीक है, इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल सेंटर फॉर आर्ट्स के ऊपर पूरा दारोमदार है टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस सेंटर, एंड इट वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर, इट वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर हेडेड बाय मिस्टर जी किशन रेड्डी, ठीक है, जी किशन रेड्डी इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कल्चर एज वेल एज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ टूरिज्म, ऑलराइट। एंड रिमेंबर थ्रू दिस इनिशिएटिव इकोनॉमिक वैल्यू ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ जीआई प्रोडक्ट्स इज एनविजन्ड, ऑलराइट। And as I already told you, the implementing agency is Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts. And SBI ने जो MOU किया है उसमें इसने ये बोला है that we will give rupees 10 crore for implementation of this center. ठीक है, so SBI has agreed to give rupees 10 crore under its CSR initiative for this particular project. All right. And एक National Culture Fund का भी नाम आया था. So remember, it is a trust under the Ministry of Culture, and it has the mandate of mobilizing resource for restoration of tangible and intangible heritage of the country, ठीक है, और ये भी काम करता है किसके अंदर, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर के अंदर, ठीक है, ये भी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर के अंदर ही काम करता है, ओके। मूविंग, लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन, नाउ वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, ठीक है जी, इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट हमें इसमें आइडेंटिफाई करना है। सो नंबर वन, द इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी फॉर द सेंटर इज नेशनल कल्चर फंड, नहीं, ये पहला ही स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट मिल गया हमें, इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी नेशनल कल्चर फंड नहीं है, इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल सेंटर फॉर आर्ट्स है, इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल सेंटर फॉर आर्ट्स, सो दिस मस्ट बी द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस टू दिस क्वेश्चन, सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर बिकॉज वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, ओके। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, Where had National Design Innovation Network been established under National Initiative for Design Innovation launched in 2014, and it is also nothing new. This program was launched in the year 2014, ठीक है, and under that a National Design Innovation Network had been established, पहले established हुआ था, but क्योंकि इसके respect में एक reply submit हुआ है in the parliament, so that's why we have to discuss it, because ऐसी चीजें एग्जाम में पूछी जाती हैं, ठीक है, थीके? जो भी स्कीम, जो भी प्रोग्राम न्यूज में आता है पार्लियामेंट में, जिसके रिगार्डिंग रिप्लाई सबमिट होता है, उसके रिगार्डिंग क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकता है एग्जाम्स में, ऑलराइट। सो टॉकिंग अबाउट नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर डिजाइन इनोवेशन, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2014 विद टू ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, एक्चुअली द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव इज ओनली वन, एंड दैट इज प्रमोटिंग द कल्चर ऑफ इनोवेशन डिजाइन एंड क्रिएटिव प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग, ठीक है, तीन बेसिक जो इसके हैं ऑब्जेक्टिव वो ये है, प्रमोशन ऑफ कल्चर, प्रमोशन ऑफ इनोवेशन डिजाइन एंड क्रिएटिव प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग आइडियाज, ठीक है, एंड फॉर दैट 20 डिजाइन इनोवेशन सेंटर हैव बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड, वन ओपन डिजाइन स्कूल हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड, एंड वन नेशनल डिजाइन इनोवेशन नेटवर्क हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड, इट वॉज एडवाइस्ड टू एस्टैब्लिश ऑल दीज थिंग्स in the year 2014, and currently all these things have been established, ठीक है, आज का जो status है उसमें सारी चीजें already established हो चुकी हैं, okay, so 20 DICs, design innovation centers have been established on hub and spoke model with 64 spokes, and where are these 20 DICs, कहां कहां पे हैं ये, so these are at 10 IITs, 10 IITs में है, 9 central और state universities में है, और एक कहां पे है, school of planning and architecture में, ठीक है, so these 20 DICs are located at 10 different IITs, 9 different center or central or state universities, and one at center for school of planning and architecture, all right. Talking about open design school, so it has been established at IIT Bombay, and National Design Innovation Network has been established at IISc Bangalore, which is Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, okay. So that's it about this news, and now let's come back to the question. The question is, this National Design Innovation Network kahan pe established hua hai? So it was established at IISc Bangalore. Option D is the correct answer. Okay. I hope guys this question is clear. Now let's talk about the Sehat OPD portal, which is a portal being implemented by the Ministry of Defence, or you can say being controlled by the Ministry of Defence headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh. So Sehat OPD portal is a patient to doctor system where the patient can consult a doctor remotely through the internet. Alright. So इस question में ही Sehat OPD portal के बारे में बता दिया गया है. It is nothing but a patient to doctor center from through which a patient can have consultation with the doctor digitally. Okay. थ्रू द इंटरनेट बोला मतलब ऑफ कोर्स थ्रू एनी स्मार्टफोन और यू नो लैपटॉप या टैब किसी भी चीज के थ्रू ऑनलाइन कंसल्टेशन या यू कैन से डिजिटल कंसल्टेशन ली जा सकती है. इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन मई 2021. व्हिच मिनिस्ट्री हैड लॉन्च्ड फॉर इट्स पर्सनल, कौन सी मिनिस्ट्री ने इसको लॉन्च किया था? ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. नाउ मैंने आपको पहले बता दिया आंसर, द आंसर इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डिफेंस. सो ये लॉन्च हुई थी मई 2021 में. देन व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट टुडे, बिकॉज the reason is that the Ministry of Defence has started the home delivery of medicines under this particular portal. इस portal के अंदर जो भी person consultation लेगा, उसको home delivery of medicines दी जाएगी. Alright, and full form याद रखना, services e-health assistance and teleconsultation. Services e-health assistance and teleconsultation is the full form of Sehat. This is also important. Please do remember this. Okay, बाकी चीजें basic है वो हम already question में पढ़ चुके हैं. So that's why the correct answer is what? Ministry of Defense headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh. Let's talk about question number 6 then. In which IIT, Global Center of Excellence for Affordable and Clean Energy, has been established to provide incubation support to startups in the area of clean energy? Again, very very important question. ठीक है, ये भी काफी important question. आज के session में सारे ही question काफी ज़्यादा important है. So let's talk about this. Remember, it has been established at IIT Dharwad. So Global Center of Excellence. Now this Global Center of Excellence is for what? It is for clean energy basically. कहाँ लिखा है यहाँ पे? Clean energy के लिए है, याद रखना. अगर लिखा नहीं है तो मैं PDF में अपडेट कर दूंगा. यस, यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है हेडिंग में, इन अफोर्डेबल एंड क्लीन एनर्जी. Alright. So this Global Center of Excellence for Affordable and Clean Energy has been established at IIT Dharwad in the presence of the great Professor K. Vijay Raghavan, who is the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. This center is supported by CSR donation from an organization which is Honeywell Hometown Solutions India Foundation. Honeywell Hometown India Solution, Solutions India Foundation, sorry. And the Center of Excellence has been established for skill development, research and development activities, and for providing incubation support for solutions to the problems in the area of affordable and clean energy. Okay, so itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. And the correct answer therefore is what? IIT Dharwad. Option E is the correct answer to this question. Moving ahead to question number 7. Which of the following work plan has been approved during the second ASEAN digital ministers meeting with India? ASEAN digital ministers meeting hui, the second edition with India. And during that, a work plan was approved. एक work plan approved किया गया है, ठीक है? Remember, that is digital work plan 2022. ठीक है? Digital work plan 2022 was approved during the second edition of India-ASEAN Digital Ministers Meeting. And what is the objective of this particular program? ठीक है? इस program का, इस जो work plan है, ये जो digital work plan 2022 है, इसका objective क्या होगा? So there are three broad objective. Number one, capacity building and knowledge sharing in emerging areas of information and communication technology. Number two, to strengthen collaboration between India and ASEAN countries in digital ecosystem. And number three, it will combat the use of stolen and counterfeit mobile hand cases. ठीक है, so basically ये जो तीन है, ये जो objective है, ये याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. This is just for the basic understanding that what are the objectives of this digital work plan 2022. Okay, so therefore I have already told you the answer. Digital work plan 2022 is the correct answer, option C. And the last question for today, with which of the following organizations Meta, which is nothing but the new name of Facebook, has partnered to support 5 lakh women led small businesses across the country under its She Means Business program? Alright, so the correct answer is FICCI. The Meta has partnered with FICCI, Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, under its She Means Business program. ठीक है, ये partnership किस चीज के लिए हुई है, ये question में mentioned था already, टू सपोर्ट 5 लाख वुमेन लेड स्मॉल बिजनेसेस अक्रॉस द कंट्री. हमारे देश में जो वुमेन लेड बिजनेसेस है उनको सपोर्ट करने के लिए, एंड टोटल 5 लाख सच बिजनेसेस विल बी सपोर्टेड अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम. ऑलराइट, एंड दिस पार्टनरशिप रिमेंबर वाज अनाउंस्ड एट फर्स्ट नेशनल वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप समिट 2022 व्हिच वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मेटा. ऑलराइट, so that's why guys the correct answer will be what? FICCI. Option C, FICCI is the correct answer. Now can you tell me who is the chairperson of FICCI for the year 2022? Please write down in the comments. Only one question for today. FICCI ka chairperson kaun hai 2022 ke liye? Alright, so that's it for the session today guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye, take care and God bless.